I want to just begin by giving a shout out to the expandable brass band of Valley Treasure, which is here providing fun and music for today's ceremony. Before I begin, we have some speakers that I want to introduce to you, but I just want to do a quick timeline for people of how we got to this place today and this beautiful new public space in the heart of our downtown. Some of you may remember back in 2005, 2006, there was a proposed hotel to be built in the Roundhouse parking lot. And at the time, our BPW, based on a lot of public input, decided that it would be important for us to start looking at Pulaski Park and looking at the park and how it could be improved or redesigned. The last time Pulaski Park was redesigned was actually 40 years ago this month, July 1976, during the bicentennial, was the last grand opening ceremony of Pulaski Park, led by the late Mayor David Kramer, who sadly passed away in November. I had so hoped that he'd be here for this grand opening, but I know he was really excited to see this new generation of Pulaski Park. So 2007, a Pulaski Park Schematic Design Committee was appointed, and Nancy Denig, one of our local landscape architects, volunteered to help work with that committee. Are there any members of that committee that are here? And if so, can you raise your hand? I was. So we want to thank them. They worked on coming up with a basic schematic design that they recommended to the BPW. And in 2008, the BPW, after reviewing it, getting public input, issued a request for proposals for a park redesign, and had a lengthy public process. There were, I believe, four submissions that came before them. They held public meetings. They displayed the designs, the schematic designs, at the APE Gallery on Main Street. And ultimately, in 2009, selected a design submitted by Stephen Stimson Associates to receive a contract for the design. Unfortunately, it was to receive a contract pending identification of funding to fund the contract. And of course, as we know, in 2008, 2009, the state and the country went into a major recession. There were significant budget cuts at both the state and local level. That schematic design was sort of put on hold for a while. Fast forward to 2012, and our state legislature and governor approved changes to the Community Preservation Act law, the CPA law. Basically, the change allowed cities and towns for the first time to be able to use CPA dollars to renovate existing parks. Previously, under the original law, you were not allowed to use those funds to renovate an existing park. So in 2013, we began the process of applying for both CPA funding and state grants to try to advance that schematic design and begin the process of funding the redesign and construction of the beautiful park that you see today. So before we go into the speakers, I just want to do a number of thank yous and acknowledgments to the many people who played roles in this particular in getting us here today. Obviously, I mentioned that original Pulaski Park Schematic Design Committee and landscape architect Nancy Denig. The Board of Public Works. Are there members of the Board of Public Works here? Former Board of Public Works, please raise your hand. I saw, there's some right there, and I saw David somewhere as well. There's David, so big shout out to them and the work that they did laying the groundwork for where we are today in terms of that design. The Community Preservation Committee, which is chaired by Brian Adams, is members of the CPC. Are any of you here? Raise your hand. Yes? Okay, great. The Community Preservation Committee, as you know, has the task of trying to decide between the many different projects and priorities that are put before it in the areas of affordable housing, open space and recreation, historic preservation, and they have to really make some tough decisions about how to spend the dollars that we as taxpayers contribute through our CPA surcharge. This project was one of the bigger ones in scope that they had seen. It actually ended up being five separate applications. It got broken down into five separate applications. And there were some moments where we were concerned whether it was going to actually advance. But I want to commend the CPC for the scrutiny and the public process that they led to ultimately recommend both funding the design and then ultimately funding $1.45 million for this phase of construction. The City Council, I want to acknowledge members of the City Council that are here, and I know Councilor LaBarge and Councilor Carney are here, Vice President O'Donnell is here, Dennis Bidwell is here, Gina Louise Sierra is here, the Council President, who has been a huge, Elisa Klein is here, the Council President, Bill Dwight, is obviously been a huge supporter of this project. He's actually selling pies in Florence right now and couldn't be with us, so... But he sends his regards. The City Council has the task of taking those recommendations from the CPC and deciding which ones get funded. And so again, the City Council has been a staunch supporter of this project. Other city staff and departments, a number of city staff and departments have collaborated on this project. Everyone from our Planning and Sustainability Office, Central Services, Parks and Recreation. Parks and Recreation has the fun of being able to actually now manage and program this park. Our Building Department, Finance Department. But most importantly, I want to recognize our Department of Public Works. Our DPW is in charge of caring for and overseeing the construction of our public utilities and parks, and they were intimately involved at every step of the way in making this project happen, from those grant applications to the CPC, to overseeing the incredibly complex design and construction process for this particular project. So I want to call up our DPW director, Donna LaScaglia, to say a few words and to recognize the DPW's contribution to this project.
Okay. Thank you, Mayor Narkowitz. Good afternoon. It's my pleasure to have the opportunity to acknowledge those associated with the department who helped to make this project possible and to bring this phase of construction to completion. I'd like to thank the members of the former Board of Public Works, Jim Larola, the former city engineer. And Ned Huntley, the former department director, for their efforts in advancing the design. Jim Larola worked to apply for and secure the grant funding to develop and refine the design with Stimson and Associates after extensive public input and outreach. And he also worked to develop the bid documents for construction. Jim's contributions to this project cannot be overstated. Thank you, Jim. David Belletta, now the city engineer, oversaw grant administration, the bidding process, construction coordination, and the entire utility relocation process from bidding to ultimate completion. And Diane Rossini of the department's engineering division acted as the city's on-site inspector for the construction coordination and utility relocation piece. David and Diane's impeccable attention to detail and coordination efforts with so many people helped create to what you see today. The Department of Public Works, working in conjunction with the city's Central Services Department and Mountain View, will work to maintain the park in the spirit in which it was constructed. The park is an incredible asset to the city, residents, and visitors, and it is a testament to the power of collaborative effort. Everybody wins today. Thank you, and enjoy.
Thank you, Donna, and I too want to echo your thanks to Jim Larola, because when I mentioned those five applications and the five times that we had to go before the CPC, that was Jim going before the CPC. I was there with him a few times, but again, I want to thank you for all the work that you put into this project. The next person that we want to have speak, when you look at this design, it really is gorgeous, and we owe a great debt to our landscape architects, Stephen Stimson Associates. Stephen and Lauren Stimson have been just incredible to work with. They helped lead our city through an incredibly open and inclusive public design process. They helped, literally helped Northampton re-envision its downtown park and helped translate the vision that people brought to them through community meetings into this gorgeous and green, accessible, family-friendly public space in the heart of our downtown. So it's my great privilege to introduce and thank Stephen Stimson Associates, and welcome to the podium, Lauren Stimson.
Okay, I know you are all getting very warm out there in that south-facing lawn, so I will try to be brief. I do have something prepared that is slightly emotional because this is a big deal for us, working in our backyard, so bear with me. Can you all hear me?
Yeah.
Great. Okay, I'll try to speak up. My name is Lauren Stimson, and I'm a principal and a landscape architect with Stephen Stimson Associates. I represent the team of designers and consultants that worked on the re-envisioning of this park. 8 years ago, we won a competition to redesign Pulaski Park. We were thrilled. Many of us in the studio had actually gone to UMass. We were familiar with this place. We knew Northampton and the Valley really, really well. Unfortunately, after the excitement, like Mayor Narkowitz had said, there was no funding. The project was shelved for almost 5 years. We had all but forgotten about it until late 2012 when Jim gave me a call and he said, "It might come back to life. Are you interested?" That was the beginning of the design process, and here we are today with you. This city is a melting pot. There's a distinct sense of history here. The farming, the river, the mills, the industry, it has real authenticity. It has grit. A connection to the past. What I love about it, though, is that it's coupled with attitude. An attitude about shaping its own future through social and environmental change, freedom of speech, boldness with diversity. We started this entire design process by engaging all of you, the community, and we asked you, what do you want? Through a process of public meetings over 6 months, we heard multiple things: a civic plaza, a large lawn, a play area for children, a performance space, flexible gathering, places to sit in the sun, in the shade, a sustainable water feature, something for everybody inside this tiny pocket of a park, expressed in a way that celebrates the heritage and the atmosphere of this city. We also did a lot of research. What was this land before it was actually a park? We discovered it was always open space. It was always common land since the colonial settlements as far back as 1653. Animals grazed here, public markets occurred, and eventually at the turn of the 20th century, the first public park was built. And at the time, it was actually on the banks of the Mill River, which actually was right over there. Many years later, in the 70s, the park was rebuilt. And here we are, 2016, and the city has rebuilt it once again. This is the natural evolution of a landscape. It isn't like a building or architecture that's static. A landscape is made of living things, of plants, people, water, soil, and the needs and functions of these living things transform with the seasons. They mature with age and they change over time. The park you see here today is an interpretation of what is distinctly Northampton right now. But we believe the elements are flexible enough to grow with your community over the next century. The Main Street Plaza is the new front door. Permeable pavers, local stone, this heroic curb cut that extends into the entire park for 150 feet. It takes dirty water off of Route 9. This is an unbelievably progressive thing to do in New England. It has not been done yet at this scale. You are the first city to do this in this region, in this part of the country.
all of these things say welcome to Northampton. This is a city that cares about its environment and the way it can contribute to a healthy regional ecosystem. Movable furniture in the plaza, a 50-foot long urban lounge, an expansive south-facing lawn, festive string lights, a nature play area. They all support the lively social scene, but they also give you flexibility and options for how you want to use the park. These elements encourage you to be here late into the evening and throughout every season. The grove of trees behind us that we saved, planted below with a woodland garden, give form to the ecological history of the site, restored with many of the same ground covers you would have seen on the banks of the Mill River. And the new materials of the park reflect the history and culture of the city. Industrial rolling carts that people are sitting on in the plaza, rusty steel, they're all a nod to your Milltown heritage. The granite blocks over there, they're salvaged from an old mill in Central Mass. The water feature, the seat walls from Goshen stone, they reflect the geology and the great legacy of the farm walls built as you move west through the valley. And the play area, black locust logs for the kids to climb on, those grow on the banks of the Connecticut River. Every element in this park, visible and invisible, is considered, it's authentic, and it represents a sense of place. We made this happen because you guided us. Thank you first and foremost to the community of Northampton. I also want to thank Mayor Narkiewicz. His advocacy and support of this park throughout the three-year design process kept this entire project moving forward. Thank you to the many city council members. I recognize several of you. You were at those community meetings alongside the city planner, Wayne Fiden, the folks at the Academy of Music, the other neighbors, and all the other stakeholder groups. Thank you especially to the Community Preservation Committee. They diligently reviewed our plans, our drawings, and appropriated the significant funding for this project. And thank you to the Massachusetts Park Grant folks, because this park has already received two grants from our state. Our client is officially the DPW, Department of Public Works. The former city engineer, Jim Larilla, and his team, David Valletta, Diane, and Doug, have been the most progressive client that we've ever had, and I am not overstating that. This is the truth. We work all around the country, Texas, Chicago, Boston, building parks. It is amazing that we built a park with this much social and environmental progressiveness just in our backyard. They helped us push the limits on making the environmental ethic of the city visible through the landscape. When we proposed something, they always said, let's do it. And when all is said and done, after you spend 3 years designing a project like this, community meetings, client meetings, CPC hearings, grant applications, design studies, models, really, really late nights, construction documents, specifications, the project goes to bid. And in this case, the project went to public bid. And then you hope for the best, because you are passing on your body of work, your vision as a steward of the city, to a contractor, and a contractor that ultimately needs to build it. So we hoped for the best, and I can honestly say we got the best. We got Mountain View. They're out of Chicopee, Massachusetts. This is Steve Corrigan. Please raise your hand. Collins, John Cornell, and their entire crew are here. They've been on the project since we started last fall. We set the bar high with our expectations for this park. They understood our design intent from the beginning. Maybe it's because so many of them went to UMass. I don't know. We all speak the same language. We were always on the same page. We always knew this was going to be a different kind of park. And a legacy project for everybody involved. Mountain View's dedication to the project, their willingness to think on the fly with us, often making lots and lots of changes and improvements in the field, is unparalleled in our experience. The quality of craft, especially in the masonry, the water feature, the Goshen stone walls, it all speaks for itself. Thank you for being our partners in the rebuilding of this important civic space. So I'm finishing up, and I'm going to leave you with one final thought. I'm pregnant, which is why I'm a little emotional. I'm just going to say that. This is a big deal. The fence is down. The park is open. We are so proud of what we've built with this city. And now it's up to you, the city and the community of Northampton, to take care of this landscape. It will need your respect and your diligence. We urge you to be the stewards of this common land. Everyone can play a role, large or small. Pick up the trash. Don't tread on the plants. Respect the furniture. Clean up after your dog. This is the only public green space in the heart of Northampton. Everyone needs the space. It represents you, your values, and your community. Treat this place like an extension of your own home, and it will be here for the next generation and continue to grow with all of us for the next 100 years. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Lauren, and thank you, Stephen, who's here as well. Thank you so much to Stephen Simpson Associates and all of the work you've done on this project. I wanted to acknowledge a couple of other folks I want to thank. Obviously, the Academy of Music, which Lauren mentioned, our next-door neighbors who had to endure the 9 months of construction, and we appreciate that, and we appreciate their input into the process. I want to also acknowledge our Greater Northampton Chamber of Commerce and our Downtown Northampton Association, which have been big supporters of this project and obviously big supporters of our downtown. I did want to point out at the back of the park where folks are sitting on the back wall, there is a 100-year time capsule that was first buried back in 1976 when the park was last opened. That's a project that was taken on by the Chamber of Commerce, and I wanted to just let people know that that time capsule is intact. You're all invited back in 2076 for the grand opening. And I wanted to acknowledge, obviously, the Chamber, and I wanted to acknowledge the former Chamber Director at the time and Florence resident Paul Walker, who was in communication with us constantly about that time capsule and making sure that we preserved its history for the next generation. The other folks I wanted to mention was PVTA, Pioneer Valley Transit Authority, who worked with us to help us create that beautiful new and custom-made bus shelter, which is really designed into the park and is really going to improve the experience for people who are waiting for the bus at that really important public transit pulse point. So thank you. I know Josh is here from PVTA, and I want to thank him. There you are, Josh. Thank you. Probably the most important monument in the park is behind us. It's the Pulaski Monument. In 1929, the Northampton Polish American Societies donated the General Pulaski Monument to the city of Northampton on what was then General Pulaski's 150th anniversary, or the 150th anniversary of his death. For over 30 years, Northampton's Polish Heritage Committee has organized our city's annual Pulaski Day parade and ceremony, which happens here in this park that bears General Pulaski's name. We really appreciated the special input that was given by that committee through the renovation process, their participation in the design process. And I wanted to recognize and invite up to the podium Bob Gibowitz, who is the president of the Polish Heritage Committee.
Thank you. Mayor Narkiewicz, members of the City Council and residents of Northampton, as chair of the Polish Heritage Committee, I want to share the committee's gratitude and appreciation to all who were responsible for redesigning and reconstructing Pulaski Park. The Polish community is honored to have the monument to General Pulaski here in the park. As you know, we hold our annual Pulaski Day celebration here, and we look forward to showing off our city's beautiful park to the hundreds of people who will come to view the Pulaski Day parade and ceremonies on Monday, October 10. The marshal for this year's parade will be none other than Mayor Narkiewicz, who has done so much for the city. We look forward to having our mayor lead our parade through the streets of downtown Northampton to this park that he worked so hard to bring to fruition. Thank you.
So before I introduce our next speaker, I just want to acknowledge, as Lauren did earlier, that this project, the Phase 1 project, was funded through a combination of $1.65 million in Community Preservation Act construction funding, together with a $400,000 Parkland Acquisitions and Renovations for Communities, or PARC grant, from the Commonwealth of Massachusetts that was awarded to Northampton in 2014. We've since received a second $400,000 PARC grant to supplement additional CPA dollars that have been allocated for phase two of the project. And Northampton is extremely appreciative to the Commonwealth for its help in funding this project, both the Patrick administration, who funded the first PARC grant, and now most recently the Baker administration. Neither Governor Baker nor Lieutenant Governor Polito could join us today, but I did want to acknowledge former State Senator Mike Knapik, who is the new director of Governor Baker's Western Mass office, and I want to thank him for being here today to represent Governor Baker. Western Mass's own Mike Knapik. And I also want to thank our two great state legislators for their support of this project, both in supporting the matching funds for CPA dollars. You see, for every dollar of CPA dollars that were put into this project, about 61% of it comes from the local surcharge that we collect. 39% of it comes from a state match. And here's, thank you, Stan. 39% of it comes from a state match. As well as supporting funding for the PARC grant program, which we've benefited not only on this project, but several other projects. Representative Peter Cocott had wanted to be with us today, but he has been delayed at the State House and sends his regrets and congratulations. We are fortunate to be joined today, however, by our friend and great state senator, and also a UMass grad like me, just to continue the theme here, the president of the Massachusetts State Senate, Senator Stan Rosenberg.
Thank you. Well, what a happy day. All right, so I am the wrap-up speaker, which means I need to be relatively quick because you are all wilting out there, and I can see that. But I want to offer a couple of additional words that have not yet been spoken. So I won't repeat all of the thank yous and congratulations that have already been articulated, but I want to offer a couple that have not yet been done. I want to thank the voters of Northampton for deciding to tax themselves by joining the CPA program so that you could leverage additional state support for programs and projects of various sorts that would help this community. Your willingness to tax yourselves says to the state you want to do your part and you look for a little bit of extra help from us. So this project being funded with CPA funds locally and state funds no doubt helped leverage the PARC grants that you got as well. So the fact that you were willing to step up and support efforts to improve your community with your local tax dollars made it possible for you to attract a significant amount of state funding. And on behalf of all of the members of the legislature, I want to say thank you for doing that because that was the intention of the program, and it is working and working in spades. The second thing that I want to do is to remind you that it wasn't too many years ago that Northampton was named America's number one small art city. The number one small art city in the United States of America. Well, this park is a jewel in the crown of this city. And it is not just a park. It is actually a work of art. And it is a place that is designed to play off the natural environment that you live in, work in, play in, raise your families in. But it is also a gathering spot for people to come together, to enjoy each other's company, to share ideas, to engage in the work by building relationships and networks and you coalesce around the ideas that you want to put in place to improve your today for a better tomorrow for yourselves and your children and the generations that follow. So this is a park, but it's also a park that has been carefully designed to meet the values and the ideas and the ideals of this community so that you can gather together and experience all types of aspects of life together in this spot. And so with that, I want to close with an excerpt from Langston Hughes' poem, Freedom's Plow, which I think is apt for this gathering and for this situation and this celebration. And it's a fairly long poem, and I actually know one paragraph of it almost by heart. You won't know the mistake I make because I will make at least one, but you'll get the idea. He said, the eyes see their materials for building, see the difficulties too, and the obstacles. The mind seeks solutions to the obstacles. Then the hand seeks the tools to till the soil, to cut the wood, to harness the power of the waters. So that one man's dream is not just his dream alone, but his dream and your dream and our dream, a dream belonging to all the hands that help, all the hands that build the community, a community of hands that help. Congratulations to everyone who helped. Enjoy this park. Have a wonderful time here.
Thank you, President Rosenberg. Thank you so much for being here today. And I have thanked a lot of people today, but I also want to thank the residents of Northampton for their strong and active support of this project. This beautifully renovated public space is an example of what a community can create when it puts its collective ideas, its civic energy, and its tax dollars together for our common good. I have every confidence that our community will work collectively to take care of this beautiful space to ensure that it will be enjoyed by many generations to come. So I only have one last thing to say. As the 44th mayor of Northampton in the year 2016, it is my honor and privilege to hereby officially declare Pulaski Park reopened. Enjoy!